Now we will see the aspects of the compound hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide has the formula H2O2, that is, it contains equimolar proportions of hydrogen and oxygen. Unlike water, it has a different structure. It also consists of OH linkages, whereas water also contains OH linkages with the central oxygen atom. Here one more additional linkage, oxygen-oxygen linkage, is characteristic. This linkage is called peroxide linkage. Peroxide linkage is the linkage or covalent bond between two oxygen atoms, single bond between two oxygen atom. So hydrogen peroxide is characteristic of this linkage. All peroxides, they contain O single bond O, but no such O single bond O is present in normal oxides or even water. Here actually it is a non-planar molecule, so this oxygen-oxygen linkage forms one basis. For one perpendicular plane, there is hydrogen OH linkage. In another perpendicular plane, there is another OH linkage. So it is a non-planar molecule consisting of a common reference plane of peroxide linkage with two OH linkages in different planes, roughly perpendicular planes. This is about the structure of hydrogen peroxide. So this is the structure of hydrogen peroxide. Now we will see the preparation methods of hydrogen peroxide. What are the methods of preparation of hydrogen peroxide? Roughly some important six methods are there. All are obtained from the respective peroxides by the action of acid only, or by electrolytic method. We will see one by one. First method, so any hydrogen peroxide in general can be obtained by the action of any peroxide, metal peroxide plus acid. Metal peroxide plus acid, mineral acid, it forms metal salt solution along with the formation of peroxide. First method is by the action of barium peroxide. BaO2 is barium peroxide. BaO is barium oxide. BaO2 is barium peroxide. Barium peroxide, it is of two forms, anhydrous form and hydrated form. We have seen about the hydrated components in the chapter on water. That is, hydrated salts have some properties, anhydrous salts have some properties. Anhydrous salts sometimes tend to occur even atmospheric moisture to form the hydrated stable ones, or anhydrous salts may play critical role. That is why here we have written that BaO2 8H2O. The actual compound is barium peroxide octahydrate. 8 water molecules are in connection with barium peroxide. There is one another salt, BaO2 as such. This is called anhydrous barium peroxide. This one, hydrated salt. So hydrated salts are preferable to be used with the water, because if anhydrous salt is used, it will form the salt. The salt will prevent the further formation of the reaction, that is hydrogen peroxide reaction. Let us understand with the example. So barium peroxide octahydrate, when it is treated with the sulfuric acid, it forms barium sulfate. Barium sulfate is a precipitate. Barium peroxide is salt. Sulfuric acid, liquid medium, aqueous medium, and it forms barium sulfate salt, which is insoluble, so it is thrown out as the precipitate. 8 water molecules are now separated. It goes in the liquid layer. But one another hydrogen peroxide is also in the liquid. So the liquid medium contains hydrogen peroxide and water. Solid phase contains barium sulfate. That is to be known. Octahydrate salt, if we use barium peroxide as such, you can write the equation BaO2 plus H2SO4 giving BaSO4 plus H2O2. Correct. Reaction is quite correct. But the reaction is quite fast, so that the BaSO4 forms a protective coating over BaO2. So you have unreacted BaO2 over this some amount of barium sulfate formed. It covers the barium oxide, peroxide layer totally with barium sulfate, so that further barium peroxide will not react with the sulfuric acid. Or in other words, the reaction of barium peroxide with the sulfuric acid is for a hindered, affected by the presence of formation of layer of barium sulfate, which gets deposited over the thing. This is the drawback associated with the anhydrous salt. That is why if you hydrated salt, it will be thrown out, barium sulfate will be, it is not allowed to form a layer. It is totally separated as a globules into the liquid medium. Of course, liquid contains water and hydrogen peroxide. In all the cases, to a maximum of 30% hydrogen peroxide is obtained. What is meant by 30%? Every 100 parts, 30 parts hydrogen peroxide, 70 part water. 70 part water to a maximum. So x percent means x part hydrogen peroxide, 100 minus x part is water. So that is the first method, action of sulfuric acid on hydrated barium peroxide salt. If you want to use only anhydrous salt, you can use. In that case, you can replace the acid as phosphoric acid. So second method is by the action of merely barium peroxide. It is not hydrated salt. Anhydrous barium peroxide can be allowed to react with the phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid formula is H3PO4. It forms barium phosphate, which is also a precipitate. Hydrogen peroxide. So it forms plus hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide is in the liquid layer and barium peroxide. Of course, why it is mentioned? Everything. Water is there. We have seen that 30% is only percent. Remaining 70% is water. So it is always formed in water. So water, it is dissolved in water. That is why it is not mentioned directly. That is to be noted. And barium phosphate, there is once again, every salt has some drawback. Barium sulfate gets deposited and affects further reaction. Whereas barium phosphate has a trace amount of solubility. It is soluble means some amount of liquid medium contains barium phosphate. So it has to be thoroughly converted to insoluble. Once again, it is treated, barium phosphate, any residual soluble barium phosphate is treated with sulfuric acid to form barium sulfate and phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid is the liquid medium, barium sulfate is the solid that can be used. So that is to be, so in all these cases, the nature of anhydrous barium oxide is to be noted, barium peroxide is to be noted. So what is the role of barium peroxide, anhydrous salt and hydrated salt, how it influences, we have seen. Now we will see some more methods on the preparation of peroxide by electrolytic and other methods by using alcoholic component, we will see one by one. Now next important method for the preparation of hydrogen peroxide, if of course the another peroxide Na2O2 is sodium peroxide. H2O2 is hydrogen peroxide, Na2O2 is sodium peroxide. Sodium peroxide on treatment with ice cold solution of sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid is generally hot in nature. It has to be properly cooled. So the solution is also very dilute, 20% sulfuric acid. That is ice cold, that is treated with sodium peroxide, Na2O2, by this. So we have seen the general method, different individual methods we are discussing. So any peroxide by the action of acid will give hydrogen peroxide, is the general reaction. Now under this category, sodium peroxide on treatment with 20% ice cold solution of sulfuric acid, it forms sodium sulfate and hydrogen peroxide. Sodium sulfate is soluble in water, hydrogen peroxide is miscible with water. So liquid layer contains both. Sodium sulfate has to be precipitated. So this solution, that is a mixture of solution of sodium sulfate and hydrogen peroxide, is further cooled. During this reaction, because of this exothermicity, reaction temperature increases. Originally we have used the ice cold solution. During the reaction, because of exothermicity, temperature has been raised. Once again, if we cool, sodium sulfate will absorb water molecules. It forms sodium sulfate decahydrate. It is a hydrated salt. It is highly insoluble. So that is crystallized and separated. So crystallized means it is separated as a solid. It is separated as a solid. Whereas liquid layer contains only hydrogen peroxide and water. Every case we have seen that liquid layer contains hydrogen peroxide and water. That is another method. So far we have discussed the effects of different peroxide salts on acid. Now a different named method, Merck's process. Merck's process involves passage of carbon dioxide over cold pasty solution. Paste means pasty mass. It is neither a solution nor undissolved. So it is a mixed pasty mass mixed with water. Barium peroxide is barium peroxide is solid. Water is liquid, but barium peroxide is not dissolved. Barium solid and liquid, they are mixed to get a pasty mass. It is at very low temperature, cold pasty mass. Into this cold pasty mass, we are passing high carbon dioxide, whereby it forms barium carbonate solid and hydrogen peroxide, of course, with water in the liquid medium. So liquid medium contains hydrogen peroxide and water. Solid phase contains barium carbonate. So that can be separated by centrifugation, centrifugal precipitation. The solid mass settles at the bottom. Liquid contains a mixture of hydrogen peroxide and water. Of course, in all these methods, to a maximum of, we can get only 30% hydrogen peroxide. Remaining is the water molecules. Next important method, it is used in industry. It is called industrial method. It is obtained by the electrolysis of sulfuric acid. 50% sulfuric acid. 50% means sulfuric acid is diluted with the equal amount of water. 50% water, 50% sulfuric acid. So 50% sulfuric acid, to this current is passed. Direct current. If we passed automatically, so electrolysis means decomposition by the passage of electricity. Decomposition, lysis decomposition, passage of electricity. So it is a strong electrolyte. Strong electrolyte means it dissociates. H2SO4 dissociates as H plus. There are two stages of dissociation, H plus plus HSO4 minus. First stage, removal of only one proton. It is somewhat reversible in nature. Second stage, HSO4 once again decomposes to form H plus plus SO4 2 minus. So the H plus means replaceable hydrogen atoms. Replaceable hydrogen atoms are there 2 in number in sulfuric acid. First hydrogen atom is replaced as proton. This replacement is reversible in nature. It is not allowed, the reaction takes place in either direction. So sulfuric acid initially decomposes reversibly to form proton, and this is called bisulfate anion. Next is bisulfate irreversibly decomposes to give rise to proton and sulfate anion. All these cases are chemical reactions. We have not yet come to the stage of electrochemical process, that is electrolytic process. In the electrolytic process, this bisulfate is important. Bisulfate, 2 moles of bisulfate, it forms, it is called thiosulfuric acid, H2S2O8, and 2 electrons are liberated. So it is forming thiosulfuric acid. This thiosulfuric acid undergoes further hydrolysis. Hydrolysis means decomposition. All are in only water phase only. Enormous amount of water is present means water can also decompose. So here decomposition takes place by the passage of electricity, as well as decomposition by the solvent medium, namely water. So the reaction involves hydrolysis and electrolysis. First one, electrolysis. Electrolysis form bisulfate. Bisulfate one end, it forms neutral molecule thiosulfuric acid with the removal of 2 electrons. Now this is hydrolyzed to form hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide and regenerates bisulfate anion. Bisulfate anion. This bisulfate anion is once again recycled. So it is a continuous process. So in all these cases, the reaction taking place is only with bisulfate. That is to be noted. Bisulfate. So it is easy to realize because this H2S2O8 is intermediate. It is processed. It is not stable. H2S2O8 is not stable, but you are not storing here. Immediately it is consumed for the production of hydrogen peroxide. So in all the unstable compounds are better used as reaction intermediates. So starting material is also somewhat cheaper. Is here dilute sulfuric acid, 50% sulfuric acid. Only aspect is associated with this passage of current. So it requires passage of current, electrolytic process. This is one. Now, because of the ease of this process, ease means easiness to extract, of all the methods, it gives maximum purity hydrogen peroxide. Last method, by the oxidation. Here, there is a substance called 2-ethylanthraquinol. It is organic substance. 2-ethylanthraquinol. Let us recall what we have studied in organic chemistry. This refers benzene. This is 2 benzene, naphthalene. 3 benzene ring systems. This is called anthracene. Anthracene is the fused 3 benzene ring system. Similarly, benzene, 1 hydroxybenzene is called phenol, para dihydroxybenzene is called quinol, Q-U-I-N-O-L. Quinol is para dihydroxybenzene, benzene with the 2 hydroxyl groups on the opposite corners of the benzene ring, quinol. So it contains anthraquinol, means anthracene base. Anthracene base means it contains 3 benzene rings fused together in this fashion. This is the structure of anthracene. So this structure of anthracene, everywhere you can see the alternate double bond, 1 2 3 1 2 3. Here it is not strictly. So this is called anthracene. In this anthracene, the central ring is containing hydroxyl groups. This is called anthraquinol. Now, anthracene numbering, you have to be careful about the number. How many carbon atoms are there? Let us start numbering how many. It may appear as though it contains 6 into 3, 18 carbon atoms. It will not contain 18 carbon atoms. Once again, all the carbon atoms cannot accept substituent. Let us recall once again what we have studied. This is benzene. Contains 6 CH linkages. All 6 carbon atoms, they can accept substituent. Substituent means you can replace hydrogen atoms. This is called naphthalene. Naphthalene, this benzene ring also 3 double bonds. This benzene ring also contains 3 double bonds. Naphthalene, let us illustrate. Already we have studied many times this 2 structure. We have to be careful in separating this one. This compound is called naphthalene, whereas this compound is called biphenyl. Both are made up of 2 benzene ring. This is called bridged benzene ring system. This is called fused benzene ring system. Naphthalene also 2 benzene ring system. Biphenyl also 2 benzene ring system. Here C6H6, one hydrogen atom is left, C6H5. Here also C6H5. If you see the formula, C12H10. C12H10 is the molecular formula for biphenyl. But here, let us number 1, 2. The idea is that they differ in the number of carbon atoms and hydrogen. It will not contain 12 carbon, it contains only 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, only 10 carbon atoms. But out of 10, biphenyl contains 12 carbon atoms. Naphthalene contains only 10 carbon atoms. Of these 10 carbon atoms, they are not numbered like this. Just to note that carbon atoms I have numbered. Actually, this numbering sequence is wrong because the central carbon atoms should not be included in the numbering because they cannot accept substituent. If you compare the valency, this double bond, there are 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this carbon valency is already satisfied. 2, 3, 4. This carbon valency is also satisfied. So the central two carbon atoms, they cannot accept substituents. Since they cannot accept substituents, they are not numbered. 7, 8. So maximum 8 substituted derivative is possible for naphthalene. Similarly is the case with now we have illustrated only for naphthalene. Now let us coming to the case of anthroquinol. Anthroquinol is the this type of system. 3 benzene ring system in the fused manner. Central benzene ring consisting of the 2 OH groups in the para position. This is called anthroquinol. That are how it is numbered? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here you should not number because already valency is satisfied. 5. This cannot be numbered. Already valency is satisfied. 6, 7, 8, 9. This cannot be numbered. And 10. This cannot be numbered. Even though it contains 6 plus 4 plus 4, 14 carbon atoms are there in naphthalene, but only 10 carbon atoms can accept substituents. So to a maximum 10 can be numbered. Let us not bother about this numbering etc. Just to understand, here we see this is first, this one is second. It is called 2 ethyl anthroquinol. Second carbon contains C2H5. So, the ultimate structure of this compound, 2-ethyl anthroquinol, this is called anthroquinol. And another variety is called central double bond. So, here the structure we should not forget, this is called quinol, whereas this one is called quinone. Q-U-I-N-O-L. This is Q-U-I-N-O-N-E. Quinol is a dihydroxy derivative, alcoholic derivative. Whereas quinone is the diketoning. C-O is ketone. Diketone. Quinone is diketone and this one quinol. So that is to be noted. So anthroquinol. Anthroquinol means central containing normal benzene ring. Quinone means central containing this type of quininoid ring. This ring is called quininoid ring. Quininoid ring means H carbon atoms containing C double bond O. So, bearing in mind these facts, lastly, let us rewrite the structure, molecular formula, I mean structural formula for 2-ethyl anthroquinol. First, anthracene, 3 benzene ring. Quinol means all in the benzene ring system. Second system contains hydroxy. So, 2 hydroxy, this is called anthroquinol. Numbering 1, 2. Second, CH2, CH3. This is the compound, 2-ethyl anthroquinol. So, this compound is subjected to the air oxidation. So, we should not forget our aim. Our aim is the preparation of hydrogen peroxide by oxidation method. 2-ethyl anthroquinol on oxidation, it forms 2-ethyl-anthraquinone plus hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide, because air contains oxygen. Air contains oxygen. Oxygen of air is converted to hydrogen peroxide. Anthraquinol is converted to anthraquinone. It is merely a redox reaction. Anthraquinol is oxidized. So, if we write the structure for this compound, this is the compound 2-ethyl anthraquinone. This is anthraquinone, alternate double bond anthraquinone, CH2, CH3. Here OH, only O. Removal of hydrogen. Removal of hydrogen is nothing but oxidation. Anthraquinol is oxidized to anthraquinone, whereas air is reduced. Air oxygen. Air contains a mixture of nitrogen and oxygen. Nitrogen is inert. Oxygen content of air is reduced to hydrogen peroxide. This is ultimately a redox reaction. This is one type of method where the air oxygen is converted to hydrogen peroxide. Now let us recall the difference in structure and molecular formula of these species one by one. First let us see the structures and we can see the difference in molecular formula. So it may appear as though different geometries, different hexagon with a ring inside it is given. We are aware this is benzene. Benzene means it contains C6H6, that is it contains 6 CH linkages with alternate double bonds, that we are aware, alternate double bonds, 6 CH linkages are there. This is the ultimate structure. Here if you remove one hydrogen from benzene, the unit is called C6H5. Two C6H5 units are connected together. So every benzene ring with a substituent means it refers to, with no substituent means it refers to C6H6. With a substituent means it is C6H5. Here this compound is called biphenyl. Benzene without a hydrogen atom grouping is called phenyl group. There are two phenyl groups. So this compound or molecule is called biphenyl. Biphenyl molecular formula C12H10. Now this compound is called bridged carbon system, because between two carbon atoms, two phenyl rings are connected by means of a bridge. That is why it is called bridged carbon system. Whereas naphthalene is called fused benzene ring system. Here this is naphthalene. Naphthalene balls, you are aware. Naphthalene balls, their composition only this one. Actual structure, alternate double bonds, one benzene ring, another benzene ring also alternate double bonds. So let us see, every corner in the double bond means we are aware that CH like that. But when we come to this carbon atom, we got to be careful. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four carbon atoms are satisfied. So the central carbon atom bears no hydrogen. Here also 1, 2, 3, 4. This carbon atom also contains no hydrogen. This is called bridged carbon atoms. Bridge between fused carbon atoms between two phenyl rings, they do not contain hydrogen. All other, they contain only hydrogen. So, 1, 2, total number of carbon atoms, let us start numbering. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I am numbering to assess the number of carbon atoms. It should not be actually numbered as 5. If it is numbered as 5, 5 substituent, it will not accept substituent. No hydrogen, only hydrogen if it is present, it can be replaced. So, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So there are 10 carbon atoms. C10. Hydrogen 1, 2, 3, 4, these two will not contain 5, 6, 7, 8. So, this is C10H8, whereas this one C12H12, both are contain two benzene ring systems. H10, biphenyl is a bridged carbon system which can C12H10, whereas naphthalene is a fused benzene ring system, it contains C10H8. Molecular formula is C10H8. Since the central carbon atoms are not, cannot accept substituent, they are not included in number 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 because H8, C10H8. Only this 8 hydrogen atoms can be replaced. That is why it is numbered. This is the case with the naphthalene. Lastly, coming to the case of anthracene. Anthracene, 1, 2, 3, as usual, the central carbon atom will not accept. Total number of carbon atoms are there, 4, 5, 6, but it will not accept. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11th carbon atom will not accept. 11, 12, 13th carbon atom will not accept this one. 1, so there is a mismatch. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12th carbon atom is not accepting. 13, 14th carbon atom will not accept substituent. So the system contains C14, but hydrogen you got to be careful. The rounded carbon atoms will not contain hydrogen. How many rounded carbon? 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms will not contain hydrogen. Remaining 10 hydrogen. C14H10 is the molecular formula for anthracene. So, anthracene derivatives, still you have to reduce the number of carbon atoms. Anthraquinone like that. So, we have to be careful about in assessing the number of carbon atoms of the, as well as molecular formula for the bridged carbon system and fused benzene ring system, that is to be noted. Even in this anthracene, isomeric forms are there. Lastly, this structure, this is also containing 3 benzene rings, but 3 benzene rings, how they are distributed, you see. This is called phenanthrene, PH phenanthrene, anthracene phenanthrene. It is an isomer, 3 benzene rings are not lying in one plane, 2 in one plane, third in other plane, that is to be noted. All these to be carefully noted in this structure. Now we are limiting to our constraint to 2 ethyl anthraquinol, which undergoes oxidation to form hydrogen peroxide with the formation of 2 ethyl anthraquinone. Now we can see the properties of hydrogen peroxide, physical and chemical properties along with the uses.